Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the world. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious, for his mercy endures forever. O give thanks unto the God of all gods, for his mercy endures forever. O give thanks unto the Lord of all lords, for his mercy endures forever. Who alone does great wonders, for his mercy endures forever. Who by his excellent wisdom made the heavens, for his mercy endures forever. Who laid out the earth above the waters, for his mercy endures forever. Who made the great heights, for his mercy endures forever. The sun to rule the day, for his mercy endures forever. The moon and the stars to govern the night, for his mercy endures. Who struck down the firstborn of Egypt, for his mercy endures forever. And bright and brought out Israel from among them, for his mercy with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, for his mercy endures forever. Who divided the Red Sea in two parts, for his mercy endures forever. And made Israel to pass through the midst of it, for his mercy endures forever. But as for Pharaoh and his hosts, he overthrew them in the Red Sea, for his mercy endures forever. Who led his people through the wilderness, for his mercy endures forever. Who smote great things, for his mercy endures forever. And slew mighty things, for his mercy endures forever. Sihon, king of the Amorites, for his mercy endures forever. In Og, the king of Bashan, for his mercy endures forever, and gave away their land for an inheritance, for his mercy endures forever, even for an inheritance for Israel, his servant, for his mercy endures forever. Who remembered us when we were in trouble, for his mercy endures forever, and delivered us from our enemies, for his mercy endures forever. Who gives food to all flesh, for his mercy endures forever. Who gives thanks unto the God of heaven, for his mercy endures forever. Who gives thanks unto the Lord of lords, for his mercy endures forever. By the waters of Babylon we sat down and wept, when we remembered you, O Zion. As for our crops we hunger, among the trees that are therein. Let us away captive, required of us a song and melody in our happiness. Sing us one of the songs of Zion. How shall we sing the Lord's song in the land of a gift of our captivity? If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget its skill. If I don't remember you, or let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth, if I prefer not. Jerusalem above my dearest joy. Remember the children of Edom, O Lord, in the day of Jerusalem. How they say, down with it, even to the ground. O daughter of Babylon, wasted with misery, happy shall be the one who rewards you as you have done to us. Blessed shall be he, shall he be who takes your children and throws them against the stones. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with my whole heart, even before the gods. Even before the gods will I sing praises to you. I will worship towards your holy temple and praise your name because of your loving kindness. Magnified your name and your word above all things. When I called upon you, you heard me and gave me increase of strength. All the kings of the earth shall praise you, O Lord, for they have heard the words of your mouth. They shall sing of the ways of the Lord. That great is the glory of the Lord. For though the Lord be high, yet he has respect for the lowly. For the proud, he beholds them from afar. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, yet shall you refresh me. You shall stretch forth your hand upon the furiousness of my enemies, in your right hand. The Lord shall make good his loving kindness. Mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Despise not the works of your own hands. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Song of Songs, beginning with the 5th chapter, the 1st verse. I came to my garden, my sister, my bride. I gathered my mirth with spice. I ate my honeycomb with my honey. I drank my wine with my milk. Eat, friends, drink, and be drunk with love. I slept, but my heart was awake. A sound, my beloved is knocking. Open to me, my sister, my love, my dove, my perfect one. For my head is wet and with dew, my locks with the drops of the night. I had put off my garment, how could I put it on? I bathed my feet, how could I soil them? My beloved put his hand to the latch, and my heart was thrilled within me. I rose open to my beloved, and my hands dripped with myrrh, my fingers with liquid myrrh on the handles of the bolt. I opened to my beloved, but my beloved had turned and gone. My soul failed me when he spoke. I sought him, but found him not. I called him, but he gave no answer. The watchmen found me as they went about in the city. They beat me, they bruised me, they took away my veil, those watchmen of the walls. I adjure you, O daughters of Jerusalem, if you find my beloved, that you tell him I am sick with love. What is your beloved more than another beloved, O most beautiful among women? What is your beloved more than another beloved that you thus adjure us? My beloved is radiant and ruddy, distinguished among 10,000. His head is the finest gold. His locks are wavy, black as a raven. His eyes are like doves. Beside streams of water, bathed in milk, sitting beside a full pool. His cheeks are the beds of spices, moles of sweet-smelling herbs. His lips are lilies, dripping liquid myrrh. His arms are rods of gold, set with jewels. His body is polished ivory, bedecked with sapphires. His legs are alabaster columns set on bases of gold. His appearance is like Lebanon, choice as the cedars. His mouth is most sweet, and he is altogether desirable. This is my beloved, and this is my friend, O daughters of Jerusalem. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. Behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed. For he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name, and his mercy is on those who fear him. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones. He has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers, Abraham and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The beginning is now and ever shall be. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke, beginning with the 23rd chapter, the first verse. Then the whole company of them arose and brought him before Pilate, and they began to accuse him, saying, "We found this man misleading our nation and forbidding us to give tribute to Caesar, and saying that he himself is Christ, a king." And Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" And he answered them, and he answered him, "You have said so." Then Pilate said to the chief priests and the crowds, "I find no guilt in this man." But they were urgent, saying, "He stirs up the people, teaching throughout all Judea, from Galilee even to this place." When Pilate heard this, he asked whether the man was a Galilean. And when he learned that he belonged to Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him over to Herod, who was himself in Jerusalem at that time. And When Herod saw Jesus, he was very glad, for he had long desired to see him, because he had heard about him, and he was hoping to see some sign done by him. So he questioned him at some length, but he made no answer. The chief priests and the scribes stood by vehemently accusing him, and Herod with his soldiers treated him with contempt and mocked him. Then, arraying him in splendid clothing, he sent him back to Pilate. And Herod and Pilate became friends with each other that very day, for before this they had been at enmity with each other. Pilate then called together the chief priests and the rulers and the people, and said to them, "You brought me this man as one who was misleading the people, and after examining him before you, behold, I did not find this man guilty of any of your charges against him. Nevertheless, neither did Herod, for he sent him back to us. Look, nothing deserving death has been done by him. I will therefore punish and release him." But they all cried out together, "Away with this man, and release to us Barabbas, a man who had been thrown into prison for an insurrection started in the city and for murder." Pilate addressed them once more, desiring to release Jesus, but they kept shouting, "Crucify, crucify him." A third time he said to them, "Why, what evil has he done? I have found in him no guilt deserving death. I will therefore punish and release him." But they were urgent, demanding with loud cries that he should be crucified. And their voices prevailed, so Pilate decided that their demand should be granted. He released the man who had been thrown into prison for insurrection and murder, for whom they asked. But he delivered Jesus over to their will. This is the word of the Lord. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered in the purchased Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen. O Lord, be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. Guide us to govern us, and lead us in the way of justice. With righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people, and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Pray in us, clean hearts, O God. And take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, out of the mouths of children you manifest your truth, and by the dying of the holy innocents at the hands of evil tyrants, you showed your strength in our weakness. We ask you to mortify and so strengthen us by your grace, that we may glorify your holy name by the innocence of our lives and the constancy of our faith, even to death, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who died for us and now lives and with you. In the Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen. Almighty God, you have given your only begotten Son to take our nature upon him and to be born of a pure virgin. Grant that we, who have been born again and made your children by adoption and grace, by your Holy Spirit through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the saints be honor and glory now and forever. The life of all who live, the light of the faithful, strength of those who labor and the repose of the dead. We thank you for the blessings of the day that is passing. Humbly ask for your protection through the coming night. Bring us in safety to the morning hours through him who died and rose again for us, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. O God, the Father, creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, sanctify the faithful. O holy, blessed, and glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of the forefathers. Neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. All evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and the thoughts of the devil, from your wrath and condemnation, good Lord, deliver us. From all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all lack of charity, good Lord, deliver us. From all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceit of the world, flesh and the devil, good Lord, deliver us from all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of your word and commandments. Good Lord, deliver us from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from the pestilence of famine. Good Lord, deliver us. From all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion. From all on murder and from of your holy innocence, by your holy and submission to law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, good Lord, deliver us. By your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, good Lord, deliver us. By your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly in all times of tribulation, in all times of death, and in the day of judgment, good Lord, we sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, and we please you to rule and govern your holy church in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to limit all bishops, priests, and deacons. knowledge and understanding of your word, that both by their preaching and living, they may show it plainly. I beseech you, laborers into your harvest to prosper, to make your saving. Increase our grace to hear your word. Bring into the way of truth all that are received. Give us a heart to love and fear you and diligently to hear. To bless and keep all your people and beseech you, good Lord. That it may please you to get to rule the hearts of your servants, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy, and walk humbly before you, beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and guide all judges, giving them grace and justice, and to maintain truth, so beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and keep our armed forces by sea and to shield them in all dangers and adversities. Bless and protect all who serve in thy name. We beseech you to hear us, Lord. To give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that at the harvest we all may enjoy them. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to preserve all who are in danger by reason of their work or travel. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife, we beseech you to hear us, Lord. To protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all, to hear us, good Lord. Care for those who have lost children of faith and fertility, and to provide for your children, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To visit the lonely and those who grieve, all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To have mercy upon all people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to true repentance, give us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and give us the grace of your Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to your holy word. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Give our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, to strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to be done safely under our feet. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To all the faithful departed, eternal life and peace, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy. Grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in their days and in their time. O Lord, arise and help us and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ.
Graciously hear us.
Graciously hear us.
O Lord Christ, let us pray.
Be merciful, O Father, on our infirmities, and
Father, rescue us from all those evils we now endure. And grant that in all our troubles,
look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils, and grant that in all our troubles, we may put all trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life, to your honor and glory, through our only mediator, Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we are unworthy sons of you. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of life, for the love of your immeasurable love of the world, by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of glory. And we pray, give us awareness of your mercy, so that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives.
All our days through Jesus Christ our Lord, to help with you and the Holy Spirit, for your glory throughout the world. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time, and for our Lord, you have given us all the gifts to you. We have promised three words of the Son, and one to the three gods, and the same word to the cross. Fulfill now. The Lord, thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the fellowship, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all.
Amen.